my girls, welcome to this class.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. Now, we are considering a simple, very simple polynomial. Namely, look at the screen. I am considering very simple polynomial px is equal to x square plus 3x plus 10. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Now, if we put different values of x, then we will be getting different values of px, particular value. Suppose, we are putting x equal to 25 for the first case in this very expression, in this very polynomial. Then we are getting 25 square 3 into 25 plus 10, and this very value will be represented by p25. For the polynomial, I have used the notation px, x is a variable, and for fixed value 25 for x, we should write p25 for the value, particular value of the polynomial. And we will have to calculate 25 square. Do you know the value of 25 square?
Yes, sir, it is 625.
625. And 3 into 25 will give 75 and plus 10, and the result will be 710. This is the value of p25. And for x equal to 75, it would be 75 square 3 into 75 plus 10. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Do you know the shortcut method for squaring a number whose unit space is 5? Do you know that?
Yes, sir. Like for 75.
What would be for 75 square? I am suppressing the result.
Yes, sir. For 75 square, first we need to calculate the square of 5, that is 25.
Then
the first digit, we are taking the next higher digit of it, that is 7 into 8. That is, it is becoming 56. Then we are concatenating the two results that we are getting, that is 56 and 25. So it will become 5625.
So you have said, I'll have to firstly calculate the result, 25 for 5 square, okay?
Yes, sir.
And then the next digit, 7, will have to be multiplied by the next higher number, that is 7 into,
yes,
8,
yes,
that,
sir,
is 56 will come for 7 into 8. Then the result is 5625 for 75 square.
Yes, sir.
What would be for 95 square? I am trying. Just watch and try to correct me. For,
okay,
5,
sir,
square, I am getting 25, and for the next digit, that is 9, 9 should be multiplied by the next higher number, 10, that is 90 will come, and the result is 9025. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
Thank you very much. Now, the value of p75 has been found out to be 5860. Now, I am giving some polynomials and notations, short notations, as px is being used. Now, calculate the values of p1, p-2, etc. Do you have any rough sheet there?
Yes, sir.
Just calculate and tell me the different values.
Yes, sir. For the first expression, p1 will be 0.
Will be 0, right.
For p-2, it will be? It will also be 0.
First term is 4.
Yes.
And second term is
minus 2.
Third
and
term
minus
is 2. Minus 2.
So it will be 0.
0. Okay.
And for the last term, p0, it will be minus 2.
Minus 2. Thank you. And do it for the second example.
You can proceed.
For the second example, it will be.
For p1?
For p1, it will be.
1 plus 1 plus
1 plus 5 plus 6 it
and the result
12
is
12.
12, okay. And for p minus 2, for the first term, we are getting
it will be 9
minus 8
minus
2
8,
cube, sorry, is 8, and minus sign will be there.
4 5 is 20.
4 fives are 20, and for the last term,
it will be 6 into 4.
6 into 2,
six
we are
into 2. Yes.
Talking about minus 2,
that will be 12.
Minus 12,
minus 12,
then 20 minus 20. That would also vanish. Okay.
Okay.
20 minus 20 as a result.
Yes, sir.
And what is for p0?
p0, it will be 0.
It will be 0, right. Now, I would like to define a new term, 0 of a polynomial. Have you ever heard it?
No, sir.
Okay. Now, a real number a will be said to be a zero of a polynomial if the variable concerned x here will be replaced by a and the value of the net result will be zero. Therefore, in mathematical language we can say a number a will be said to be a zero of a polynomial p x, given polynomial p x, if and only if. Look at the screen, I have used IFF, that is not any English word, this is if and only if, that is the abbreviation for if and only if, p a equal to 0. If we put a for the variable concerned here and the result will vanish, then that very number which is being put for x is known as a 0 of the polynomial. Have you got it?
Yes, sir.
For example, I am considering a polynomial p x equal to x square plus x minus 2. Then for zeros of the polynomial, the p x will vanish, and after solving the equation which is led by p x equal to 0 is x square plus x minus 2 equal to 0, after factorization I get x plus 2 into x minus 1 equal to 0. And taking one by one, we are getting two roots, namely minus 2 and 1. Therefore, these two values are two zeros of the polynomial. Is there any chance for any other real number to be a zero of this polynomial?
I don't think so, sir.
Yes, p x equal to 0 leads to the equation x square plus x minus 2 equal to 0, and I have found out all the roots. Therefore, there is no real number which can satisfy the equation. Therefore, there is no real number which can be a zero of this very polynomial. And what is for p 0? Look at the polynomial p 0. Polynomial was x square plus x minus 2. After putting x equal to 0, we get minus 2, which is not 0. Therefore, we cannot take 0 as the 0 of this very polynomial. Okay.
Okay, sir.
The same word 0 is being used here for two different meanings. Okay. Therefore, our conclusion for this page is 0 is not a 0 of this very polynomial x square plus x minus 2. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Now, I am giving you a polynomial, namely x cube plus 5 x square plus 6 x. Take some time and find the zeros of this very polynomial.
Okay, sir. So, if we simplify this expression, then it will become, first we are taking x common, then it will become x into x plus 3 into x plus 2.
Let me write, please.
Yes, sir.
After taking x common,
it
we are getting
x square plus 5x plus 6.
In the parenthesis, I am
yes,
getting
sir.
X square. Okay.
Then we are breaking it into factors, and so it is becoming x plus x into x plus 3 into x plus 2.
Okay.
So we can say that 0, minus 3 and minus 2 are the zeros of the given polynomial.
Okay. Equating this very expression to 0,
yes,
we are getting 0, minus 3, minus 2 are the roots of this very equation.
Yes, sir.
So 0, minus 3, minus 2 are the zeros, There is no possibility for any other number to be a 0 of this polynomial. So I am using the word the zeros of the given polynomial. This is exhaustive in sense. And thank you for this job. And find the zeros of p x equal to 25, I think you will be able to do that. P x equal to 25, constant.
Then, sir, the value of x has to be 0.
Okay. Say, what is the value of p 1? If we put 1 for x, what will be the value?
The value will be
25. 25. Remain the same.
Yes, sir.
What is the value for p 100?
That will again be 25, sir.
So, if we put any value a there instead of x, any fixed value, fixed real number a, then it would be 25. Hmm. So, there is no chance for making this polynomial to be 0. There is no real number which can make it a 0. Therefore, our conclusion should be, complete my sentence.
There will be no number that can make this polynomial equal to 0.
Very simple, there is no 0 for this polynomial. There is no 0. Okay.
Yes, sir.
There is no zero for this very polynomial. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then pass on to the third example, where we are taking the zero polynomial. Zero polynomial means zero. The number zero is called zero polynomial. Therefore, independent of the value of x, if we put any value, any real value for x, then the value will remain the same as zero. Next, what will be the zero for this very polynomial? Try to answer me. What will be the zero for this very polynomial?
Sir, any number of x.
Actually, 0x means the number 0, irrespective of the value of x. Okay.
Yes, sir. Then for any value of x, the polynomial will be 0.
Okay. 0, 1 is 0, 0, 2 is 0, 0, half is 0, 0, root 7 is 0, and so on.
Yes, sir.
Then we can expect any real number as a 0 of this very polynomial.
Yes, sir.
There is no number which can be rejected to be a 0 of this polynomial. Therefore, we are getting the totality of the real number as the set of zeros of this very polynomial. Therefore, we can write the set of zeros of this very polynomial is the whole set of real numbers which will have to be represented by this very R, the set of
real numbers.
The set of real numbers. Nice job done by you. Very nice job.
Thank you, sir.